Hello everyone, this is Roshi Haldar. I'm doing my PhD from University of Calcutta, India, in the subject of food and nutrition. And this is my e-presentation on the topic, an extensive review on the relationship between food and mood. In medieval times, people started to take great interest in how certain foods affected their mood and temperament. Dates, elderberries, bananas were used as mood enhancers, lettuce and chicory as tranquilizers, apples, pomegranates, beef and eggs as erotic stimulants. Studies suggest that foods directly influence our brain neurotransmitter system. In turn, mood can also influence our food choices and expectations. Thus, the relationship is bidirectional. The mood-food relationship describes how mood may influence a person's food choices. The mood-food relation. The relationship between food and mood is complex and depends on the time of day, the type and macronutrient composition of the food, the amount of food consumed, the age and dietary history of the subject. What is mood? A mood is an emotional state. Moods generally have either a positive or a negative balance. In other words, people typically speak of being in a good mood or in a bad mood. And what affects mood? Sleep is a major contributing factor to mood. Apart from that, diet, medication, and other lifestyle factors can also affect mood. How does food affect our mood? The following are some of the ways. The first one says fluctuations in blood sugar levels are associated with changes in mood and energy. Brain chemicals like serotonin, dopamine, acetylcholine can be affected by what we have eaten. There can be abnormal reactions to artificial colors and flavors in food. Reactions due to the deficiency of an enzyme needed to digest a food can also affect mood. For example, lactase deficiency can cause milk intolerance. People can become hypersensitive to foods, causing food allergies or even sensitivities. And also, size of the meal is a major factor which can affect our mood. The aims and objectives of this study. In the chicken or the egg problem of food and mood, do the mood hedge the food or do the food hedge the mood? Studies say that the relationship seems to go both ways. A couple of recent studies, though, suggest that the food comes first. And this project aims to summarize the physiochemical and biochemical relationships and the exact mechanism that binds food with mood. This study will enlighten and increase awareness of this vital connection between food and mood. Some of the reviews of literature. Tea and mood. Now, certain teas and tisanes can help alleviate nausea, boost the immune system and refresh it. And tea can also fight a very common disease, which is depression, thanks to its antioxidant content. Some of the literature reviews here can actually describe why tea is such a mood-boosting content that we can actually consume. Some of the teas here have been described, which can help to boost our mood. The aromatic scent of the tea plant provides a sense of calm. It can help lower blood pressure, especially under stress. Also, polyphenols present in the tea can help influence the dopamine availability, thus can impart mental clarity and help boost our mood. Some of the teas are sage tea, saffron tea, turmeric tea, chamomile tea, the lemon balm tea, green tea, yerba mate, ginseng tea, masala chai, lavender tea, fennel tea, and rooibos tea. And all of these are very important and very good for boosting our mood. Coffee as a mood elevator and depressor. Coffee is also referred to as a pleasure drug, is the most flavorful and potent caffeine-bearing beverage of all. Coffee increases general happiness and feelings of pleasure and increases positive mood overall. The study by Smith et al. In 2002 has stated that the effect of caffeine on human behavior and regular caffeine usage appears to be beneficial, with daily users having better mental functioning. In Rose, 2008 states that the daily dietary caffeine intake is associated with sleep disturbance and daytime sleepiness in children and in adolescents. And a very important study has stated that caffeine strongly affects the activity of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, thus influencing the body's ability to manage and deal with stress both at rest and during activity. Next, we have chocolate. Chocolate contains a lot of important ingredients that are important for actually boosting our mood. For example, sugar, theobromine, anandamide, tryptophan, and phenylethylamine, which is often referred to as the love chemical. It can cause endorphin release in the brain. Next, we have some of the happy foods. These foods, which are like the green leafy vegetables, the different kinds of seeds, the bananas, blueberries, the foods which are rich in vitamin B and D, raw cocoa, fermented foods, and wild fish, all of them contain a lot of vitamins, phytonutrients, and a variety of stress-reducing antioxidants. And these are perfect snacks to help activate the happy messages in our brain. Nuts to boost our mood. The first we have almonds. Almonds contain a lot of tyrosine, precursor to the neurotransmitter dopamine, which is of course the happy hormone. The cashew nuts are packed with numerous phytochemicals, which is converted to serotonin, the important brain chemical controlling our appetite. Brazil nuts contain a lot of selenium, which prevents anxiety, depression, irritability, and tiredness. Walnuts, also referred to as brain food, contains linoleic acid, linolenic acid, vitamin E, B6, which are all excellent source of nourishment for our brain, and peanuts contain a lot of tryptophan, an essential amino acid, which is converted to serotonin, helps stabilize our mood. Some of the more depressing foods are refined sugar and artificial sweeteners, the processed foods, hydrogenated oils, foods which contains a lot of sodium, alcohol, and caffeine. A study in 2005 has suggested that both low folate and low vitamin B12 status have been found in studies of depressive patients, and as an association between the depression and low levels of the two vitamins is found in studies of the general population. And another study in 2007 has stated that fish intake can both directly and indirectly be associated with depressed mood and depression. Some of the spices which can help boost our mood are have listed here, and spices are known to significantly contribute to the flavor, taste, and medicinal properties of food because it contains a lot of tannin and gallic acid. For example, saffron can help to alleviate the symptoms of premenstrual syndrome and depression. Coriander has antioxidant antibacterial properties which can help alleviate insomnia. Some of the micronutrients which can help fight stress, the B group vitamins, the vitamin C, vitamin E, and along with that I have listed the name of some of the foods which contain these vitamins are very good for stress fighting. And the most important minerals to fight stress are calcium, iron, magnesium, and zinc. And some of the foods which contain these minerals have been listed here along with the name of the minerals. Effect of neurotransmitter on our food intake, and this is the diagrammatic representation of that. Research has reported that people are more alert, their brain are producing the neurotransmitter dopamine and norepinephrine, while serotonin production in the brain has been associated with a more calming and anxiety-reducing effect. Serotonin production is blocked by the consumption of protein-rich food, resulting in increased alertness or concentration, or levels of dopamine and norepinephrine are increased by the consumption of protein-rich foods. This is again a pictorial representation of biological factors engaging both central and peripheral nervous system in a bidirectional manner, linking the food intake, mood, and obesity. In neutral mode, food intake decreases, and in positive or negative mood, food intake will increase. Carbohydrate or fat-rich foods are consumed due to their resulting mood enhancement. Highly anxious people are more likely to turn to food for comfort, leading to excessive eating. Depressive symptoms are associated with less frequent consumption of fruits and vegetables and meat. L-theanine, which is present in tea, is a safe, natural sleeping aid. Caffeine improves performance on simple and complex attention tasks, affecting the alerting and executive control networks. Chocolate reduces hunger, elevates mood, and eating chocolate is also followed by joy and in some women by guilt. Micronutrient supplements are increasingly being used by people suffering from depression. Different kinds of spices, seeds, seed oils, and nuts have anti-inflammatory, anti-stress, and anti-anxiety effects. So food, which is of course associated with eating and emotion, are such a regular, consistent part of our lives that it is inevitable that they would get tangled up together. Some of the references I've used for my presentation here. Thank you.